Hi everyone, Shashank this side. I hope you all are doing well today. So as you know, we are in a process of creating videos for CloudFormation, where we already covered up the concept of CloudFormation with my previous video, and we created a stack with the help of designer tool. Today, we will use YAML file to create a stack, and we will understand the code section as well, how the YAML and JSON format works. Also, I will show you how to create a stack with the help of existing template. So let's start. So whenever you try to create a template with a coding stack, you have to use few sections inside that code. So what are those sections? So these are the sections that needs to be used regardless of your JSON coding or YAML coding. First is parameters. So parameters is basically where you define your inputs based upon which you can update your resources values, which you can use at runtime. So that's how the parameter works. Basically, you have to define your values which you will gonna reference into your resources. I'll gonna show you the template that I have created for this particular video, where we have defined parameters, mappings, resources and outputs. So let's complete the theoretical part first, and I'll show you the practical demo as well. Next part is mapping. So mapping is basically where you map your values to a resources, like EC2 instance type, key name, AMI IDs. So whenever you try to create an instance, you take the reference of key name, you take AMI IDs. So basically you are trying to map those values with your resources, right? So you already have an AMI ID, or you are taking an AMI ID from existing AWS templates, where you are trying to map your EC2 instance with that AMI ID. That's what mapping is all about, where you have to define all those instance type, key name and AMI IDs. Then we have resources. Resources is basically again where you define what kind of resource you want to design. So in AWS, everything is considered as resource, like your EC2 instance, your subnets, your VPCs, those are considered as resource. So what kind of resource you want to design based upon your requirement, that needs to be defined in the resource section. And last one is the outputs. Basically, you are pulling out the resources values and you are trying to export that values to the next template. What does that mean? So let's say I have defined public subnet, I have defined VPC as my resource, and I want to use that resource values to my next template with the help of creation of EC2 instances. So what I can do in the output section, I can pull out the resource values, and with the help of export function, I can import that value to my next template. I'll show you how to do that. So these are the four important sections that we have to take care of it, regardless of your YAML coding or JSON coding. So I'll be using YAML code. As I said, I try most of the time to work on the YAML scripting. Okay, so the demo for today, what we are trying to do over here, so we'll be creating an infrastructure with AWS CloudFormation. So whenever I try to work on my projects, I try to use CloudFormation. If it is AWS in total, then I use CloudFormation to design each and every resource from the infrastructure side with help of this particular tool. So to create an infrastructure, what are the things we require? We'll be creating an VPC, we'll be creating internet gateway, which will be attached to my VPC. Then public and private subnets, we'll be creating a route, NAT gateway, EC2 instance, and take the outputs. So this is the agenda for demo today, that we are trying to cover up the infrastructure module, a basic infrastructure module that everybody uses in their environment with the help of AWS CloudFormation. So I have captured a basic diagram, the architectural diagram that what we have to do today as part of our demo. So we are creating puff private VPC, that's the name I have given. Inside that we have public subnet, we have private subnet, we are creating EC2 instance, then we have a NAT gateway, then we have two routes, public route and private route. Private is attached to NAT, and we have public route, which is attached to my internet gateway. Then we have NAT public IP. So whenever you create NAT gateway, you need to assign a public IP over here. Okay, so this is the overall layout that what we have to do it today. Now I'll jump to the YAML template that I have created for you guys for this particular demo. So this is the YAML template that we have, where we have a parameter section defining your public, private and VPC seeder. So this is the way that how you define the resources in the parameter section, like what type of parameter is this, is it a string, integer or any other number. Then this is the seeder block. So if you're not aware of the networking section, please do watch the networking series video on my channel. That clears out the understanding of what public subnet, private subnet and VPC and other related networking stuff is all about in AWS. So I'm defining the seeder blocks for private, public and VPC. Then we have a key name where we are trying to map the our key name. My key name is Windows, just to log into my environment. Then the type of resource that we have, which is AWS EC2 key pair key name. So one thing you have to be very sure, because whenever you try to create any EC2 instances, the key name needs to be created beforehand, because with CloudFormation you won't be able to create key name. That's what I have found till now. Then the mapping section is showing the instance type. So I have given the allowed values as T2 small, medium, then M4 series, M5 series. So these two are the mapping section inside a parameter. Then we have resources where we are trying to create our VPC with the help of reference seeder block. So this is the logical name that we'll be giving, pub private VPC, what kind of resource, this is VPC type. Then every resource has some properties like seeder block. So the parameter is already defined for seeder block as 16. So that's why we are trying to reference that seeder block over here. And then we have tagging. Okay. Then we are trying to create internet gateway. And you can see like these resources are in same alignment. So next is internet gateway, type of resources, internet gateway and properties. We have only tags. Then gateway to the internet route. So this is basically an attachment, VPC gateway attachment. So whenever you create your internet gateway, you have to attach that to your VPC. That's what we are doing over here. This is the type of resource that we have. So these are the things that you will gonna get on Amazon website, that I'll gonna share you the link, what kind of resource or what type of resource you have to call in your coding. Then in properties section, I'm just referencing the VPC, because inside that VPC we have to create our internet gateway. Then gateway to the route is this one. Then we are trying to create public subnet with the type subnet, referencing our VPC. Availability zone is this one, get the availability zone. Then referencing the seeder block, map launch info is true. Then we have tagging, same way for the private subnets. So public info, I have set it as false for the private servers. Then after creating subnet, you have to create a route. So I'm creating a route. You can see the type of resource is route table, referencing that in VPC. Then we have tagging. Then we have public route, where it's creating a type of resource as route, depend upon gateway to internet. Destination seeder block is all over public, referencing the route table and add gateway. Then associating that subnet to a route table. So you can see the type is subnet route table association. Again, these are few things that you have to understand, and you'll be getting all the syntax on Amazon website. I'll be sharing the link that as well. But you have to be very sure how you design the sequence. So obviously, if you have to create your subnet, that needs to be created inside your VPC. So for that, you have to create VPC first, then go for subnet, then go for route. then go for NAT gateway, kind of that sequence, because I do follow that same criteria, whatever I have defined over here. Then same for the private route, that what we have done for public. Here we are creating EC2 instance. You can see the type of resources instance referencing the instance type value. So this is getting reference from this particular mapping value. So I'll be getting an option to select E2 small, medium, large, or M5 series or M4 series. Then key name, again referencing from the above that what we have defined. Disable API termination is true. This will help you to protect your instance from accidental termination. EBS optimize is true. This will give you a better performance on your storage. Image ID, I'm directly defining the image ID because I have my own AMI created. Then I'm referencing the subnet, which is public. So I'm creating this in public subnet. Security group, again, this is defined with my security group section and the tagging. At last, we have output section. Again, this is not mandatory section. Even if you don't define this in your template, execution of your template will gonna work. So what benefit of placing it over here? When you define output section, one benefit this gives when it comes to the nested stack concept. So let's take an example where we are creating a new region within AWS. And we have been assigned a task to achieve this goal, right? So as an architect, what I'll gonna do? I'll be doing this in two separate sections. One is infra template, where we have all the VPC and networking related stuff get defined. And other instances section, where we'll be doing customer onboarding. So that's where output section will gonna help us. As you can see, I have used export function with each of the defined resources for VPCs, for public subnet and private subnet. Okay, so I can use these references in my second template so that I don't have to create my VPC and the networking stuff again and again. So that's one of the easiest tasks for us to do. Lock down your infrastructure and do the onboarding of the customers with the other template where you define all your EC2 instances. In that way, you will be very secure enough that nobody is going to touch your infrastructure until unless there is a need of it, right? So that's where the output section will gonna help us. So I'll gonna create another video with the nested stack concept where we'll be creating the infrastructure. And I'll show you how, with the help of import function, I'll be using these references to create my EC2 instances over there. So that's how this is get defined over here. Now, the next step is to go to our AWS management console in CloudFormation to upload this template to show you if this is working or not. So this is my AWS CloudFormation console. What we have to do, we have to create a stack. So click on create stack with new resources. Template is ready, yes, it's on my local. So I'll be uploading it from my local template, yes. Now click on next. Here what we have to do, let's say VPC prod is my stack name. Now, whatever the parameters that we have defined, you can see the instance type. I'll going with D2 small, key name, Windows. These are the CIDR blocks, SSH location. Click next. I'm keeping everything as default. Click next and create a stack. So this will gonna take some time to create because we are creating NAT gateway as well. That is the most consuming, time consuming process to create. So I'm gonna have this video pause for a moment, and once my stack is completed, I'll resume it back to show you guys what it has created. So our stack is completed successfully. You can see the create complete is in green status. Let's see what we have now. Go to the resources section. Let's see. it has created subnet, public subnet. Then we have public route, our VPC. Then we have NAT public IP. We got the Elastic IP as well, static Elastic IP. This is the NAT gateway ID. We have internet gateway. Then we have an instance. This is the instance ID. Let's open this in new tab. In the output section, as I said, we have referenced the values and we are exporting that value to the output section. So export name is private subnet 1, VPC prod, public subnet 1. So when we create next template with the reference of these values, so we basically have to use import function to use these values. In that case, we don't have to create our VPC and subnets again and again. Parameters, these are the parameters that we have selected. Instance type, key name, then the CIDR block, SSH location. Then, as I said in my last video, if somebody has deleted your template from your backup location, you can just go ahead to your CloudFormation and download the template from here. You can view this in designer tab as well. So let's go ahead and see it in designer. So this is the one that we have in designer. Let me minimize this. Let's see. Okay. This is quite small. Then we have this. Okay, so as I said, we have instance, this is the VPC that we have. We have public subnet, private subnets. Then we have route table. This is private, this is public, NAT gateway, then NAT EIP basically, and internet gateway. And we have a security group as well. So these are the things that we have created with our CloudFormation template. So it's just basically one template consists of everything. You don't have to design everything manually. That's what we have done in our previous videos. Okay, so let's go to our EC2 instance. Now, what are the information that we have over here? We have the public IP, security groups, then the private IP, custom VPC. So let's go to custom VPC as well, subnets. And rest of the default that we get, like owner ID and all those things. Okay, so next part is like, let's try to hit this URL. We should be getting, yep, it's working fine. So that's our AMI consisting of Apache. Now let's go to VPC. So this is the custom VPC. As you can see, we have two VPCs now. One is custom, one is default. Then we have subnets, which should be something private and public, and both are into the same VPC that what we have created. Then we have a route table, public route and private route. So if you go to the public route, into the route section, you can see we have a gateway to internet route and the association of public subnet. Even if you go to the NAT gateway, this is the one that we have, 54.236.78.229. So see, how easy is this to get everything at one place? You just have to define in one particular file all your coding stuff. This will gonna give you everything without doing any manual intervention. That's how simple it is. But let's say if you have to enable a accidental termination, what you have to do, go to VPC prod stack section, and there is something called edit termination protection, enable. Now in this case, if anybody tried to delete this accidentally, then this will gonna say like edit termination protection first disable it, then delete it again. In that case, you have to be very careful with the permission that you give to your team members, because if you delete it, then you will gonna lose everything whatever you have defined with CloudFormation template. That's why it is dangerous as well. Okay, the next step that I want to cover up with this video, create a stack with existing template. So again, go to create stack, use the sample template. Let's say we have a WordPress blog. You can use LAMP stack as well, Ruby on Rails, or WordPress blog. So WordPress blog, it's showing this template installed WordPress with local MySQL database for storage. Okay, click next. You have to give name WordPress, then the DB password. Let's say we have password is test 1234. Root password test 1234, user admin. Select the instance type. You can see all the instances are available over here. So T2 small, key name is Windows, SSH, all over the world. Click next. This is the tagging. Click next. And when you hit create, this will gonna create the WordPress blog for you guys. So that's how simple it is. You can create your own WordPress blog. You just modify it and show it to the world that this is my WordPress blog and I'm doing all the blogging stuff over here. So this again will gonna take some time to get created. If you go to the event section, it has already created a web server security group and the web server is in progress. So if you go to our EC2 instance section, we'll be seeing one more instance getting created. Yep, this is the one that is getting created for WordPress. So once this is done, our stack will get into the green state. So our stack is green now. WordPress website is up and running. If you go to the resource section, you will gonna see web server and the web server security group. In the event section, you will gonna see all the logs. Create complete is green. In parameters, that what we have selected, the DB password, root password, user, instance type, and SSH location. So these are the things that we are getting with our existing sample template. That's how simple it is. You can create your own WordPress blog. You can create your own LAMP stack. If you don't want to create your template by of your own, if these are the sample templates fulfill your requirements, then that should work for you. So I would request you to go through the tutorial again. Try to create more templates as per your requirement. Try to create your EC2 instances, your security groups, storage. And I'll be sharing all the syntax information with Amazon website link with my description section. So please go through that. If you're facing any issue, just place out a comment in comment section and I'll be there to help you. Have a nice day. Bye-bye.